Trapoil is an independent oil and gas exploration company with the focus very much on the UK continental shelf, which basically means North Sea. Let's find out more now about the interesting model that Trapoil follows with the chief executive, Mark Groves-Gidney, who joins us now. Mark, welcome.
Hi, Jerry.
I mentioned the model at the top because it is a very interesting model. Explain a bit more about what it is you're doing.
Yeah, well, it is quite unusual, as you say. We created the business model when we were private, so some 4 years ago, 5 years ago, and it's all based off a very close relationship with the world's largest seismic contractor. We get access to their data. From that database and with our technical expertise, we create opportunities, and we basically move those opportunities onto large oil companies.
This contractor is CGG Veritas?
CGG Veritas, yeah. So in return, the large oil companies pay us cash on an annual basis, which helps with the G&A. But more importantly, they give us a carried interest all the way through to the date of first oil production. So this means we don't have to put our hand in our pocket for license fees, for seismic, for wells, appraisal. Even the development capex is covered by these oil companies. And only on the first day of production do we then pay back an element of the development cost.
Just as an aside to that, I'm interested to follow up with a question as to why more companies don't do this.
Well, I think, you know, it is a niche that we fill, and the history of the company is based off of our technical expertise. So in theory, other companies could do it if they had the advantageous access to the seismic and a strong technical background. So I guess is the one thing that we pride ourselves on is we're a technically led company with access to these databases. And of course, once you've attracted the big oil companies, you then become quite a powerful consortium into license rounds.
Of course. The free carry thing, whenever you mention free carry, investors get interested. What's the investment case? I mean, you've got the free carry element to this, which clearly is an attractive proposition, but what's the full investment case?
Yeah, well, when we IPO'd back in March 2011, we set ourselves two targets. Basically, one, to become a very active UK North Sea explorer, as you've outlined already. And the second was to buy enough production that we had a sustainable business, cash flow and tax efficiency. It's very important now in the UK with the tax regime as it is that you have tax efficiency. So this means if you spend money on dry holes, you can basically recover it from your profit stream from the production. So we've achieved both our IPO promises within effectively 18 months of the IPO. So we have a very sustainable company. We have, as of the end of last year, end of 2012, we had £8 million in the bank, and we're now earning £2 million a month after all expenses. So really it's a cash cow now, or a cash accretive business, because all the exploration we're doing is carried, as we've just discussed. So we have no outgoings other than a nominal amount of G&A. Which even our partners are helping to contribute towards.
Yeah, so following on from this, you've got this income every month, and you've got a £30 million market capitalisation. Yeah. Let's look at the share price and the market cap of the company in relation to the earnings that you're getting and the potential.
Yeah, well, obviously at £30 million market cap, it's pretty much the cash accretive business from the production. So the exploration at the moment is coming for free. Okay, we're not paying for it, but it's not recognised in the share price. So the reason for that is because although we had a blue chip register at IPO 18 months ago, we've lost a couple of institutions along the way. Some hedge funds left pretty much straight after the IPO. And then a couple of long-only funds have gone, including one just quite recently. And, of course, when they press the sell button, suddenly the marketplace is flooded with shares, and it takes a while for that to be absorbed. On the other hand, we have actually attracted two very large long-only funds into the business post-IPO. So it's not all a one-way street. It's just the fact that the share price obviously reacts when there's a big overhang. And unfortunately, that's what we've had quite recently.
Mm. The UK is a crowded market. What sort of edge have you got?
Yeah, well, that's an interesting question, because we are actually working on a project right now. It's in its infancy, but we're looking at the potential of bringing non-conventional oil play into the North Sea. So there's a lot of documentation about how successful it's been in North America. It's almost changed the economy, turned it on its head over there. So we're looking to see if there's an opportunity to bring that technique where you're basically fracking rocks that don't normally flow in terms of large commercial volumes of oil. So we see if we can frack them, recover oil, and it's a very much a volume game. Then you have to drill multiple wells to recover the oil. So, as I say, it's in its infancy, but we've put all the work together, and very soon we'll be going to approach major oil companies. We're working closely with DEC. Some of the things that will need to be changed are the licensing regime here in the UK, because obviously the extraction of this type of oil can take 25, 30, 40 years, and at the moment the licenses are only handed out for 15 to 20 years. Mm. So there's a lot of things that have got to be changed, but it will be a game changer if it works, not just for Trapoil, but for the UK economy as well.
OK, so you've laid out the store. Where do you go from here?
Well, the key is obviously our track record in exploration. So to date, we've drilled two wells and had two discoveries, so we're very happy about that. We have two wells drilling as we speak, Scotney and Magnolia. So the proof will be in the pudding in another 6 weeks' time, I guess, the results of those wells will be known. In terms of looking forward, we have a suite of wells. Some of them are partly carried. Some, indeed, we are going to step up to be operator because they're relatively small assets, but they're discoveries. So these are the ones where we need to be in control of our own destiny, be the operator, make sure they get drilled in 2014 and monetize them for the shareholders. Now, going back to the core exploration model, one of the key things we've got to do is not only refresh the opportunity set in there, but also make sure we're working with the right partners who are hungry alongside ourselves to pick up new assets. And we are actively talking to a couple of large oil companies to come in and join us in future work, basically the 28th license round, which will probably be in early 2014. And they'll be the companies that come in and provide us with a carry.
OK, well, we'll look forward to hearing about that when that news comes out, because clearly that could well be a turning point, well, another milestone at least.
Yeah.
Talking about milestones and where the company's going, do you see, I mean, you're an exploration company, obviously you're looking for opportunities. Do you see yourself going outside the UK continental shelf?
No, one of the things that we really pushed when we IPO'd was that we were going to be a very focused UK company. Obviously, the people in the company have expertise beyond the UK North Sea. But as a collective group, you know, we work very well together, and the access to the databases, that's all UK North Sea. So it's a company that's very focused on the UK North Sea. And again, that makes us a little bit unusual, because most companies do, over time, spread their wings.
Well, we've gone back to where we started. An unusual company, interesting proposition, and some news due to come shortly. So we'll look forward to that, Mark.
Okay.
But in the meantime, thanks for joining us and updating us on what Trapoil's doing in the UK continental shelf. That was Mark Groves-Gidney. He's the CEO of Trapoil.